last full day and last night before we go home tomorrow. We're headed for Washington, Georgia to stay overnight at a place called Calloway Plantation. I guess they have an open-air museum of buildings built in the late 1700s and little RV sites nearby. So, but it's a nice drive out in the country right now. Pretty nice, but we got here and I was gonna check the weather and I couldn't find my phone, so I asked Tony to call me, and we could hear it up in the cab of the motorhome but couldn't find it. And lo and behold, we don't know how it got there, but these are the steps going down, and it was under the cover of the stairs.
It fell off right here, and you must have put the cover in. You were lucky it didn't get crushed.
Yes, I was. Very scary. Okay.
Okay, we're set up at Calloway Plantation. This is site 3. Pulled in that way. And good and level. A little bit rustic, which is good. 50 amp, got water and sewer connections. Really nice over here. All full hookups, $25 a night. Picnic table, and we're back right up to the old, I guess, plantation houses. I don't know what all this is back here. We haven't explored anything yet. We just got set up, but everything's looking good. We will wander up to the store in a minute. Looks like a cemetery off to the right here. All right, old farmhouse, museum, we'll take pictures. Take it easy here today and relax, and then we'll be able to do some cleaning and get rejuvenated for showers and dumping the holding tanks, and then the last hour and a half ride home would be pleasant. We can just put the motorhome right up, except it's kind of dirty. I don't know who's gonna wash it. Just a quick walk through the campground before we go check in at the country store to see how hard it's gonna be to get out of here.
Doesn't look like it's going to be too bad other than the hill.
All right, here's not bad. Just make a loop. So, looks like we might have the only one there.
Hello. Hey. What do you think? What do you got it all fixed up. Wonderful. Rent by the month or something?
They must do. We can ask them when we go to the store. they look for almost, they got a whole house.
That must be why it says unavailable.
Yeah, they got somebody living there full time. Look at that.
Yeah.
That's outrageous.
That is squirrel.
Man. Yep. That one would be difficult to back out of. Well, I guess you would have to come in. You'd have to come in the opposite direction and back in. This one you could back into. We could go right here if we had to on
this
one. Yeah, that one would be good. It looks fairly level. You pull straight up and back in, you know.
Yeah.
Owned by the city of Washington, eh? Massachusetts.
Puppy's in there, bar parking.
Yep. Oh, look at the old log cabin up there.
Well, good. So we can just pull around to get out then.
Oh, yeah. Looks like we just go straight forward. Don't even have to unhook the Jeep.
Yeah, that's good.
Nice little walk.
Uh-huh.
We might want to do a hike down the road later for some exercise, eh?
Yep.
All right, babe.
Birdies chirping.
Nice change from the hustle bustle.
Spring is coming out.
These little city and state campgrounds are nice. They're not very big. Sometimes you have to be concerned about access with our motorhome. But in most cases, they give you a lot for the money. About half price, and you got a lot more nature and a lot more privacy, which is nice. Hey, look at this wild animal, babe. Hey, log cabin, daily cabin. Oh, people can stay there.
Circa
1840.
No.
Yeah, I guess so.
Let's go in it.
Can you go in it? Yeah, it's unlocked.
It's unlocked for a minute.
Yeah, it's
Dolly
unlocked.
Dolly cabin.
Yeah.
You think this is one of the slave cabins?
Dolly.
Oh, Dolly?
Yeah, it's a slave cabin. Look at this. This cabin moved here from Walton County, Georgia. Oh, it's a gift from Gene Dolly. One of the oldest residential structures in Walton County. So it's not a slave camp.
There's no list of the names of the enslaved that has been found thus far of the Parker Calloway years at the plantation. At the event of Parker's death in 1868, the institution of slavery was, of course, over. So there was no will, inventories, etc. listing slaves
Those
by their
the
names.
Ones that were in his will from 1803. Huh.
Wow.
So it didn't say this was a slave cabin. Dad.
Oh, it's got it by year. How many slaves he had? 105, 118, 155 in 1860.
Jeez. Man. So when he died, he only had two slaves. But over there, he had several.
But they wouldn't
like.
Be considered slaves anymore, right? Or would they?
No, that was Dolly, John Dolly. Now, Parker Calloway Plantation.
Oh, yeah.
In 1860, had 155 slaves. That's a lot of slaves, I think.
Yeah. Well, he had, wasn't there 4,000 acres originally or something like that, or no?
3,000, I think.
Three, yeah.
Man. So, is this a slave quarters or is this a... It doesn't really say, does it? You got a bedroom suite in here. Can't see too well. Slatted boards. And a big fireplace. I mean, the fireplace is enough to keep this place warm. In the summertime, I guess you got to open these big windows. Oh, there was a loft up there too. But it's, no, it's, well, no, I'm not going to go up there. Oh, yeah, they got it blocked off so you can't go up there.
A master bedroom?
A master bedroom, yeah.
Well, a bedroom.
Okay.
And a back door.
Oh, look at there. You opened it, babe. Let's see what's... Hey, there's a bridge over there.
Yeah. It'd be nice.
Nature trail. We'll have to walk that. That's the nature trail that goes over the little wooden bridge over there. Okay. All right. Pretty interesting. Got the in between the cracks they put the clay. Not a very big, but look at that. I guess upstairs there was more sleeping quarters. Yep.
Virgil Kane is my name, and I drove on the Danville train till so much cavalry came and tore up the tracks again. In the winter of 65, we were hungry, just barely alive. I took the train to Richmond that fell. It was a time I remember oh so well. There goes the Robert E. Lee. Now I don't mind, I'm chopping wood, and I don't care if the money's no good. Just take what you need and leave the rest. But they should never have taken the very best.
The night they drove old Dixie down,
and all the bells. People were singing, they went la 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 la. Like my father before me, I'm a working man, and like my brother before me, I took a rebel stand. Well, he was just 18, proud and brave, but a Yankee laid him in his grave. I swear by the blood below my feet, you can't raise the cane back up when it's in the feed.
The night they drove old Dixie down,
and all the bells. People were singing, they went la 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 la.
Yeah. There it is. There she is.
Good. You just checked in for the site group. Oh, yeah.
Brown.
Is it your cat?
Oh, I've always got the money. Okay. Looks like the airport, doesn't it? Yeah, probably an airport. I won't be able to fly my drone if I wanted to anyway. No big deal. Galloway Country Store. Huh?
Gray House, plantation plain style, oldest Callaway residence, hand sawed lumber. Wow, it looks really nice.
Never sold from the original land. Can you believe that?
Where are you?
Oh, right at the very bottom. Man.
And the family still owns considerable acreage. Wow.
Can you imagine, though, if you had the original land grant? Look at this over here. This is all part of it, I guess.
Well, that's what I was just reading. Right there, Gray House.
Okay.
Oldest Callaway residence.
Is that Gray House?
Yeah.
And it's got a thing on it. Are we going to do the tour now, or you want to go get... I mean, I'll do what you want to do, babe. Oh, here's the sign, babe. So... the oldest one is over here. We can go do those two, Log Cabin and Gray House, now, and then come back and do these, or we can do...
Yeah.
I mean, because we got all afternoon. The reason I was looking, it looks fairly modern with the, you know, with the gray siding to be the oldest residence. Signs around the other side, but they might have one on this side too. Log cabin is 1785. Oh yeah. Man. This is... Wait. Watch where I step. This was the original... This is where it was originally built. They didn't move this one, eh? Baby, the sign and all is around the other side, yeah. And look down there, they got something does smell, doesn't it? Hey, look, they got air conditioning. I didn't step in something. Nope. Man, 1790. So they kept the kitchen separate so they wouldn't burn down the main home if the kitchen caught fire. Isn't that's what they told us in Texas too, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. It says it was built right across the airport and they moved it. So really it was built fairly close, within a few hundred yards. The airport's right across the street. Man. You'll see if a door opened, they got it all locked probably. Yep.
I thought she said the Gray House was open.
Try that door and see.
Yeah,
okay, I'll see. And it's not open. We might have to go back and ask her to pay her $7 for a guided tour. This one's got a padlock on it. Okay. Originally had a dirt floor. Man. That's amazing. What you see over there?
That should be the living room, which also served as the parents' bedroom.
Yes, picture George Washington on the wall over there. Can you believe that? Windows are kind of dirty, aren't they? And you got upstairs too. Nice dining room. Tall ceilings. Well, it's got a padlock there. 1785. Huh. Cooking. Somebody's left a propane. Must have been boiling some peanuts. All right. Well, I guess this was the recycle bin right here. Open air skylight up there. This is about down here. I guess if we pay the money for a guided tour, they'll explain all this to us. Looks old. This is supposed to be. I think somebody just left them there. Make it look picturesque. Huh. Can you see anything, babe? Yeah. It's hard to see. I must have done some renovations on it. Yeah, something smells out here, doesn't it? Shipped to England.
It's a sweet smell, but on the pungent side.
Yeah. It's a shame that the factors or the brokers made more money than the planter did, you know, the middleman.
Yeah.
Yep. That's the way they do it. There's several of these old bathtubs filled up with flowers. An airport right across the street. Man. Well, it's funny how they had to separate all the houses so that if one burnt, it didn't burn down everything, you know. Yeah. In here where they had to do the ironing, they had to have a fire going.
Weaving thing.
Yep.
Locked.
Yep. This is the well house.
The front block.
What's that across the street there? Smokehouse.
Smokehouse.
1875. Man. Here you go. Manor House. Man, died before it was ever completed.
Oh.
Two bricks thick, man. Tax for the number of rooms. So they kept their money in England from the last cotton shipment after the Civil War and came back 4 or 5 years later and finished the house. A separate dining room. You wouldn't think brick would burn, though.
What's that, the board, the kitchen, or warming
system? Yeah, yeah. Aristides, Calloway. Can you see anything in there?
Old wooden floor.
Yeah.
Piano right when you walk in the door.
It's a better view. Yep. Windows all dirty. Hard to get good pictures. Man. Well, we won't be able to see upstairs. I don't know what that is. They hand hewed it out, a big log. Walk around to the front. Funny, they've installed air conditioning.
Yeah, after the fire.
So one shipment of cotton, they had enough money to build this house. Can you believe that?
A lot of cotton.
Yep, every year they were doing that. Man, with the wind blowing, I don't know what that smell is, but it's still pretty pungent.
Yeah.
In God we trust. Back up a little here. Wind blowing too hard, babe. plaques up here.
Oh, this is what they were talking about. They raise this up and then you can open it.
Oh.
To let the breezes in.
Big piano. And that's an old ancient looking thing.
Oh, wow. That's the second piano because there was one in the foyer.
Yep.
Those wooden blinds, they need to get out of the way so I can get some pictures.
Mm-hmm. That shows the staircase going up.
Good light in there.
Library.
Looks like it's got the original furniture.
Mm-hmm.
Man. Look at this.
Man, how they painted back then.
I don't know.
A lot of paper.
And the thing is, this is not one of the larger plantation houses. I mean, this is kind of a modest style. If it weren't for the Civil War and they kept planting cotton, they could have probably built something four times bigger than this and never missed a beat. It's amazing though, during the period of Reconstruction after the Civil War, they were able to come in and build their own plantation house with the money they had stashed in the bank in England, eh?
Yeah.
Look at where this big old tree was at one time.
Oh, wow. Way
bigger than that. Yep. Walk over to the red building. Assuming that's a schoolhouse. We have a one-room schoolhouse here. Yeah. Well, I'm assuming they must have built this for building a fire, I would assume. I don't know. And sugarcane, you know, they got a sugarcane grinder here. It actually says cane mill. Put the sugar cane in one side and you got something underneath to catch the, actually the juice comes out right here and then just grinds it right through there and all the juice comes out the bottom and you have a big pan to catch it in and then they take it over to the big pot they have under the fire where they're boiling it and condensing, boiling the water out and condensing it down to sweet syrup. I was a little boy.
Yeah.
I was a little boy. I remember going to the cane, actual real life cane cooking. And they'd give us sugar cane to chew on. And my mom would get syrup. And they'd also be making homemade soap, lye soap, and other big cast iron pots. It was a big social event. But those traditions have long gone now. You think this is a little red schoolhouse? Hey, we do have a plaque that tells us something about it.
Thomas Gilmer House.
Okay. He grew tobacco. Oh, that one's actually open.
Creepy.
Go ahead, babe.
Yeah.
I don't think they mean for it to be open.
You don't think so? Hey, we could restore some of this furniture. That looks like a nice chair here.
We got enough old furniture.
Hey, just like one of our computers. Hey, that's heavy duty too. Nice chair. You got a man in Aiken that can restore them. George Gilmore born. Oh, that's a picture of his headstone. Right there. I don't know what it comes through in the movie. Oh, look at this. I don't know how they did the little slats.
Store it, or they just use it. I don't know what they do. What they're using it for.
It reminds me of the old farmhouse my grandma, my mom's mom and dad lived in Georgia. Yep. It's even got the same kind of smell to it. It's probably the same. Man, look at this fireplace. Probably the same kind of house, you know, same kind of floors. Yeah. Man. Yep.
We
go upstairs. Go ahead, babe. I'll go first. If I fall, you holler for me. Let me get lost up here. Oh,
there's some short, steep steps.
Okay. Well, not really. It's just an upstairs. It's pretty steady if you want to come up here. It's got an old smell to it. There's no fireplace up here, so I don't know how you'd keep it warm in the wintertime.
Yeah, just heat rises, huh?
I guess. Okay, you see?
Yeah, it's
all right, let me see if I can get down. All right. I know. Okay, this is the 1891 schoolhouse. Original teacher's desk.
Recitation bench. Original handmade students' desks.
Man.
Yeah, the glass panes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's open.
Yeah, this one she said was open.
Okay. Dress up, baby. Let me get a picture of you. You don't want those dresses. At least wear a hat. Do they put these hats here to give away? Look at that. Oh, that's... Yeah, that's a Confederate hat. There's one, too.
Hey, it fits.
Turn around. Oh, I don't know. General Beauregard. Yes. That's Catherine. Are you going to try that on?
No, I'll just do this. How about the hat?
Which hat? This one?
That bonnet.
Is this it?
Yep, the bonnet.
Hey, this is U.S. This?
Do I dare put it on?
Uh-huh. It doesn't have... Oh, this says Confederate States of America. It can't be. I wonder where it's made. Does it say made in China? Hey, babe. Man, you could be a real Southern Belle from Chicago. Get over here. I can't get you in the light with the light coming through there. You need to come over this side.
Oh.
Yeah, that's better. There.
There.
Now stand still. Let me see. What a Southern beauty.
Oh.
They got a mirror there to help you.
Oh, I can look. Oh, wow.
Teachers. 1899. 1892. Man, they went through the teachers every year. They had a different one. Up to 1928. Huh?
You know what it's like teaching those little stinkers?
Yep.
Whoa, risque.
Teacher, 1918.
Hey, isn't this one of the...
Man, she looks pretty stern.
British hat, doesn't
it? Yeah, it does.
Yeah,
uh-uh. Okay. All right, get up there and teach us a lesson, babe. Hey, look at the early pupils.
It's not the schoolhouse. It's the old Wilkes Club.
Yep. Captain Alexander, President Simpson, Booker. Huh. Judge Thomas Meriwether. Got some famous people in there.
So it's at a resuscitation desk and the teacher's desk.
East Wilkes Club in 1885. Man, very distinguished looking pupils there.
Here's the employment rules for school teachers. Dress must not be more than 2 inches above the ankles. You cannot dress in bright colors. And at least 2 petticoats must be worn. You're expected to be home between the hours of 8 p.m. and 6 a.m. Oh, so no going out at night.
Teachers will not marry or keep company with men during the term of their employment.
Jeez, they got to be here at 7 to
start. Can't get in a carriage with any man except for father or brother. Can't go order at ice cream shops. They didn't know they had them right there. Not smoke cigarettes, play card, not dye our hair under any circumstances. Got to attend church. Hey, that sounds just like St. Mary's, doesn't it? Not leave town without permission of the chairman of the school board. It sounds just like St. Mary's. Hey, babe, get some glasses. Play the piano for me, babe. You're very good. Okay. This was the original teacher's desk. Okay, Miss Catherine, if you don't behave, I'm going to send you home. Put you back on that leash. Oh, man. No. I can't imagine. They don't even have a bathroom in here. Little Johnny raising his hand, saying, Miss Jenna, I need to go to the bathroom. Well, cross your legs, Johnny.
Well, they try it already, but I'm
not. Yep. Okay.
All right.
Yep. The good old days, baby. All kind of outbuildings.
Blacksmith shop?
Mm-hmm.
It's just a replica. Yeah. Pigeon house, looks like that one.
Right, it's that right there.
They could raise pigeons as they were called to eat.
Yep. They call them squab. You wouldn't eat a pigeon, yeah. But I remember my grandmama's house, my cousin Tommy, going up top, and they had a pigeon. They were keeping pigeons in the top of the back of barns. They had an opening at the end. They'd come in.
But why did they have pigeons?
They would
eat them.
Yeah, they call them squab. But it's not to everybody's palate now, though. Yep. That's a good, nice-sized little, I guess, grass cutter or hay baler machine or whatever they call them. Keep the grass cut down. Harvest the hay. Man. Georgia, 1936. Colorado. That's the best one.
So this is... What Willis
Anderson. What did the headstone say?
She hath done what she could.
Wife of Willis Amerson. What was her name? Cassandra?
33. Cassandra Moore.
Huh.
Man, poor thing.
Man, this old drill press. Wonder how they got it operating. Oh, they had to turn it by hand. I wonder if it's still turned by hand. Oh, yeah. Look at that. You could do some drilling with that. Huh. And then here's a... Man. You got it hooked up to propane. Yeah, they got some stuff out of period here, some electrically operated stuff. Looks like some people still working in here and some stuff. Oh, wooden vise. Look at that. Man. You see the cotton bales back here, babe?
No.
Yep, bales of cotton. Here, souvenir.
Oh, wow. Man, look how soft it is.
Oh, yeah. Man. Okay. You didn't want your souvenir.
What am I going to do with it?
Uh-oh. Careful, babe.
I broke something.
I didn't hear that. That thing really hot and do something with it. But funny thing is, instead of firing it from the bottom, they have propane hooked up from the top. Okay. No, it's got a few things.
Tools,
well, some old files and stuff. You got to watch these nails up here because that doesn't feel good on your head. I can tell you from experience.
Don't worry, I'm not going in.
They put that there just to aggravate people with thin skin heads. Oh, here you go. some old wagons and stuff. We just need some mules. Tin roofs. Got brakes on them with the wooden chocks. I wonder if we can get through over here. Just walk over. There's a cemetery over here I saw. Right over the block over here, the blocks straight over there. I think that's a cemetery. That's what they got a stadium for. I mean, a stage for music. And they got some bleachers here. And I guess people can come sit around. Look at this. And they can have entertainment. Be nice if we could come get that spot number 3 and be here for their festivals. Yep. I thought this was a cemetery when I was looking in a while ago. Find the entrance in here. Eugenia. She didn't live very long, did she? Mm-hmm. There's one died 1861. Man. Are these?
Eugenia Selloway Lindsay, born 1834. Passed away right before her 60th birthday.
Okay, so these are just the headstones for them.
No, it's different.
Oh, it's different?
Yeah. That Artisades or whatever it is, Aristides, that was the son of the original guy on this plantation.
Right, okay. He wasn't born until 1823. Yeah. And the original one was in the 1700s. Arthur, okay. It's a sheep up there, not a doggy.
That means it's probably a baby.
Well, this is Arthur, 1872, 1873, 1 year old, yep.
Aww.
Yeah. 1 year old. That's terrible. Well.
This person was born in. I can't tell. Is that a
1822 died 1853.
So that must be a brother to this guy. Aristides, huh?
I don't know. Eugenia, 1834,
1894. Man, so these people lived through the Civil War.
Yep.
Pretty tough. This guy passed away before the Civil War. Well, when did he start?
1860. Yeah. Now, this fellow here, Seaborn, might have died in the Civil War. You never know. Smelled like old rotten, you know, grain or mesh. That's what it smells like. See if we can sneak through here back to the motorhome, take a shortcut. I think we can get through there. All right.
On that road or do that
later? Let's do that later.